Paris, would the president really push out his own daughter?
I don't think the president would utilize his chief of staff to push out his daughter, but I do think if that conversation was going to be had, he would have it directly with Ivanka. We have to remember she's in a unique position, being his daughter and being a trusted advisor throughout the campaign and now in the West Wing. And so what we have to remember is simply this. The president does not want his daughter, someone who he loves, to have these negative headlines and to be attacked personally like she is. And so he has to figure out, is it best for my daughter's counsel to be inside the White House or outside the White House?
So what do you make of Maggie's reporting then that runs counter to what you would certainly expect from the president relating to Ivanka Trump?
Yeah, I don't know if I believe Maggie's reporting, to be quite honest with you.
Why?
Because I don't think that's how the president would operate. And I do know that what can be done is that the president, he seems he'll put something out in the orbit, or people will be allowed to say certain things that aren't actually as it seems. And so that may be the narrative that they're putting out there, but that may not be the actual truth of how this is going on.
What do you think, Bill?
I have no problem believing that Donald Trump would ask John Kelly to throw Ivanka, his own daughter, under the bus. But I think the important thing is that he would just do it. I mean, he cares about himself. He doesn't care about anybody else. But I think that the problem here is, look, they look like a nice couple. I don't know them. Their family, but they've caused nothing but trouble for Donald Trump since they've been in the White House. It is double trouble. So Jared has all these loans with these foreign banks. He can't even get a security clearance.
That's just not true.
Stories this morning.
Well, he can't get a security clearance.
He has a security clearance. Well, let's be accurate.
He has a security clearance.
It is not at the highest level.
He can't get a
that
top.
That interim one was revoked.
He cannot get a top security clearance, and yet supposed to be in charge of the Middle East and prison reform and Mexico and all of that.
Why do you need a top secret?
And then Ivanka, Ivanka is out there still hawking her products. She's getting bad publicity. I just think the president would be better off. He would be better off if they just went back to New York.
Paris, the president came out, tipped his hand about his plan for tariffs on aluminum and steel. And it seems to go against what so many people close to him are saying he should be doing. They're not happy with it. They're upset with it. What do you think about him disregarding all of that advice?
At the end of the day, he's the president of the United States, and the president makes the decision. He gets the advice and counsel from those around him, but ultimately, on matters of domestic policy, international policy, foreign affairs, he makes the final decision. The people voted for him for his decision-making ability and for what he wants to, how he wants to guide this nation. And so he makes the best decision based upon what he believes is best for the American people and American interests and businesses.
But I think this speaks to a problem, Brianna, which is nobody knew what the hell he was going to say before this meeting. John Kelly wasn't even in the White House at the time. They did not know. He said, maybe I'm going to do it, maybe I'm not going to do it. Nobody in Congress knew. The people in that room didn't even know. So the decision-making process, David Gregory just made this point with Wolf, is really broken down. We don't know where he is on guns. He has this big meeting. He's not really said, I'm going to do this. Yeah, I'm going to take on the NRA, but then he doesn't. Now he walks into these tariffs. I mean, the whole place is out of control.
And then he targets Alec Baldwin with a tweet. He says, Alec Baldwin, whose dying mediocre career was saved by his terrible impersonation of me on SNL, now says playing me was agony. Alec, it was agony for those who were forced to watch. Bring back Daryl Hammond, funnier and a far greater talent. That original tweet, we should mention, sent at 4 a.m. And there are people, as our Gloria Borger is reporting, close to him, Paris, who want him to succeed, as you do.
As we all should.
Who are worried that he is unraveling when they see things like this.
I think, today's Friday, correct?
Yes.
Tomorrow's Saturday. Saturday Night Live comes on tomorrow night. He's going to reprise the role. He's going to be doing it again. The president is known to get up very early. He operates off very little sleep.
This is early even for him. Right.
I mean, he had a very early day today. He was just at Billy Graham's funeral, which was a wonderful service. And he's been leading this country in the morning for Billy Graham very well, with dignity and with honor. And so I don't think this is anything more than what President Trump normally does. He tweets about, and quite frankly, Daryl Hannah is a lot better and is a lot funnier. And that's the truth.
You know, you have to admire somebody like Paris, who will go to any length to defend anything that Donald Trump does.
I like
Let
the
me
truth.
Just say this. I'm, as president, he's my president too, okay? I want to believe that when Vladimir Putin says, we've got missiles now that can get around any U.S. defense system, I want to believe when the National Security Advisor, McMaster, looks like he may resign. Gary Cohn, the Chief Economic Advisor, may resign. Rex Tillerson may be out. He's attacking Jeff Sessions. Now his daughter and his son-in-law are maybe on their way out. I want to believe the President of the United States has more important things to worry about, even at 4 a.m., than Alex, as he calls him, Baldwin. I mean,
deleted, then retweeted with Alex spelled correctly. But Paris, final word.
The president,
maybe final word.
The president can multitask and do many things at once. But the average lifespan of any White House employee, which I have served 18 months. This administration, it might be a little bit shorter because of all the intense pressure that's happening. So these departures that are speculative, Rex Tillerson went on the record with 60 Minutes and said he's not going anywhere, and he is 100% behind this president and this administration.
You can't believe anything any of them say.
We can't believe anybody serving in government because they're working for the president.
Back to Alex Baldwin. But the problem is the president is the
tabloid. So you want to focus on Alec Baldwin rather than all the other
things
going on.
In fairness, I asked about Alec Baldwin.
And
he went back to Alec Baldwin.
Asked the question. I did, because I want to make the point. The problem with the president is he's more interested in cable TV or SNL than in running the United States
of America. No, he's interested in tariffs and trade and national defense.
He's the tabloid president. And let's face it, TV's over, Mr. President. Run the country.
He's Bill running Press, the country.
Paris Denard, thank you so much to both of you. And just ahead, outgoing Republican.
Don't forget to click subscribe. It's almost as satisfying as skip ad.